Hello guys, my name is Amit Sani and I welcome you in this daily PIB analysis video. In the evening, these videos come. In the morning, the Hindu editorial videos, they come. And don't leave any lesson. Both are having separate datas and both are extremely important for the prelims point of view. If you seriously want to clear the UPSC prelims this year, then don't leave any of these lessons. These compilations are extremely important. And the PDF you get on the Telegram channel and on the Facebook group of mine, Amit Sani group for IAS preparation. So there I upload these datas. And this is the number where you can ask for these pen drive courses by StudyIQ. These are extremely important, created by experts, selected people, and all the static syllabus and all these things, they are covered under them. You see, Election Commission of India, it has come up with a helpline number 1950. Okay, 112 was regarding the emergency and specifically women and child helpline, and it was started the way America has 9/11, India will have 11/2, and it was by Ministry of Home Affairs. Next, Security Council, UNSC, it has 15 members, 5 permanent as P5 countries, USA, UK, France, China, and Russia, and 10 non-permanent members, and these are elected for 2 years, not 5-year terms. So this is wrong and this is right. Only one is going to be the right answer here. BrahMos is a joint venture between India and Russia. That's correct. This is wrong because it is a cruise missile. And that's your homework. Find out the difference, that which one is a cruise missile and which one is a ballistic missile. I give you a hint. I draw a particular picture here and just tell me what is the relation of this particular picture here with the ballistic missile and the cruise missile. Okay, so that's your homework. And ballistic missile is unmanned rocket propelled. It's not self-propelled and it's a guided vehicle. So two only is the correct answer. Both these options, statements are wrong. Fourth, which of the following is the smallest moon discovered around Neptune? The name is Hippocamp, and it is very famous these days because it's a small one and a lot of discoveries are still left to know. And it's regarding the Neptune planet. It's the ice giant, as we call it. Next, DPCO, drug price control order. State of Kerala actually has come up with this DPCO as a first state, and this drug price control order, which is gonna control the price of essential drugs. There is a essential drugs order 1955, and according to that they are going to check that is there any kind of violation of prices and any kind of concerned company is involved in profiteering out of this noble profession. So they will check that thing, and two only is the correct answer. First is wrong because Tamil Nadu is not the correct answer. Kerala is the right answer. Next, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. MSME Ministry's first conclave on empowering marginalized sections. Okay, and especially women entrepreneurs. This is going to happen tomorrow in Mumbai. And you see, this SCST hub initiative is going on for the MSME industry. And especially the women entrepreneurs, they are main focus because these are the main working groups. And they are very sincere and they are always following the right initiatives and schemes. So first of its kind conclave endeavors to empower women entrepreneurs from marginalized sections. It's a first of its kind conclave. Remember this. And you see, there are going to be enterprising women of the year awards 2018 also. It is happening for the first time. So award for 2018 for the first time. So that's important. Remember this, micro, small and medium enterprises industry. And this SCST hub initiative is going on. Okay. Now, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs data, Apex Conference of Chief Executive Officers of Smart Cities Mission. You see, this Smart India, Smart City Mission that was started 2-3 years back, and it is going on. Evaluation is consistently happening and they are giving rankings for these cities, and they are trying to make them digitized and very fast. All amenities would be there and environmental friendly, all smart cities. It's a mission, and we also discussed about them today in the morning session of Hindu editorial, where we discussed that around 2.4 lakh crore rupees would be invested in these cities, but only 2.4% is invested in the waste management. So that was the context where we discussed about smart city mission. Okay, so that the waste management was the problem. But you see here, this news is regarding a particular conference, Apex conference, which is going to happen in Delhi, and the main questions, particular focus to discuss would be on how smart cities mission is creating connected communities, urban resilience, sustainability and smart governance, as these are the core ideas of being a smart city. and 130 experts from several countries, not only from India, outside from India also, they are gonna participate. So this may be an important detail that whether anyone is coming from outside the country. Next, Prime Minister Office data. You see, this National War Memorial, that was in discussion for some years now, and it was the dream of Prime Minister Modi, and now they have come up with this war memorial and near India Gate in New Delhi. You see, India Gate is famous as a war memorial, but that was the First World War, and the soldiers that went in the British Army from India, their name is actually engraved on the India Gate in New Delhi. So near this particular India Gate's monument, there this National War Memorial is going to be there. There are four concentric circles, okay, concentric circles, and namely Amar Chakra, Circle of Immortality, Veerta Chakra, Bravery, Tyag Chakra for Sacrifice, and Rakshak Chakra for Protection. So these are four symbolizing concentric circles, and you see the awardees like Paramveer Chakra awardee and all, their names are actually engraved on these monuments, okay. And three living awardees are also there. Three Paramveer Chakra awardees, these sub-major Bana Singh, retired one, and sub-major Yogendra Singh Yadav and Sanjay Kumar. These are three living awardees which are having their names here. Okay, so that's important. And National War Memorial represents a culmination of the collective aspiration of a grateful nation to pay a befitting tribute to the martyrs. So you see, a lot of discussion, a lot of debates are going on, and after this Pulwama attack, this particular patriotism ambience and all these talks, all these emotions, they are actually on the surface of the country. So these things are going on, these discussions are actually a major highlight. Next, Ministry of Finance. This data is regarding the PFMS, Public Finance Management System. You see, whatever money that is being transferred through DBT scheme or any kind of central sector scheme, central sponsored scheme, if it is getting any money from the center, then the implementation and the observation and monitoring is done by the Public Finance Management System. This is a web enabled payment system and management information system, IT based application of the Government of India, and it is administered by the Controller General of Accounts, CGA, under Ministry of Finance. So this PFMS is a very important body, and you see, they're saying that it's a historic achievement that on 1st of February this PM Kisan Yojana was announced, and within 24 days this is launched, and the first installment of 2000 rupees has reached to more than 1 crore Montour farmers. So that's historical by PFMS. It's the fastest one till date. But you see, allegation is already there that these people are making it fast because elections are due, and this cash transfer scheme is certainly gonna have impact on the votes from the farmers. So that's a kind of allegation by the opposition. Next, Ministry of Railways, Rail Drishti Dashboard. This is launched here, and it is going to promote the transparency and accountability, because all the data, all the statistics is going to be there on this Drishti dashboard. Okay, whatever statistics, performance, and what are the parameters of the Indian Railways, they are being put up on this particular dashboard. There is an app and website, and this is the URL of the website. There, any common person can check about these statistics. So this is Rail Drishti dashboard. That's important. Next, Ministry of Water Resource and River Development data. National Water Awards 2018, they are going to be distributed. And you see, three states, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh, they are the top three states in water management. And the issue of Gujarat is discussed many times in the recent months, that it has done tremendously good work in the water management and the water conservation area. And you see, as the minister says, that's right, that India does not have a shortage of water. It's a very valid point. India does not have a shortage of water, but India's water is mismanaged and the rivers are not linked one. So extra water is going towards oceans, and people are remaining thirsty there because the distribution of this water is not proper. Okay, this is not equally distributed. Uneven distribution is the problem. Next, Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation data. They are coming up with employment data based on the EPF registration and ESI schemes registration and the pension scheme, National Pension Scheme registration. You see, the new Employees Pension Scheme 2004 that was started by central government and the state governments, except the armed forces, and it was extended in 2009 after 5 years to other establishments also, but not the armed forces. So the data is actually from these particular schemes. These are mainly two of them, EPF and ESI, are the social security scheme, and you may also call pension as a social security because that's practically a social security for senior citizens. So all are actually connected directly or indirectly with the social security measures of the common people, the poor people. And you see, EPF is applicable to establishments having more than 20 workers. Anywhere if more than 20 workers are working, then the EPF registration is mandatory, and employees would be contributing some amount, and employer also gonna be contributing some amount in this EPF. And EPFO as a body is established under the EPFO Act, okay, 1952. So that's important. And this ESIC is Employee State Insurance Corporation, that is also established by the ESIC Act 1948, and it is mainly for the manufacturing establishments where more than 10 workers are working. So for the EPFO it is 20 or more workers, and for the ESIC 10 or more workers. But if it is the health and medical institution, then more than 20 workers should be there. And actually, in the incidences of occupational hazard, maternity, sickness or employment injury, these people are supported by the state insurance scheme. And the wage ceiling is 21,000 per month, means more than 21,000 if any person is earning, then he would not get any kind of benefit under ESIC. So that's the problem, and that is the limit here, okay. Otherwise, it's a very important social security scheme, okay. Next, the NPS is applicable to any citizen of India. Remember this, any citizen of India, whether resident or non-resident, NRIs can also avail this, but the age group should be 18 to 16 years, 60 years, and the Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, PFRDA. It is actually managing this. It's a regulatory body, and it is managing the National Pension Scheme. And it's a low cost, tax efficient and flexible portable retirement saving account. Retirement saving account, remember this, because the money is given after retirement. So it's a pension scheme, okay. And individual contribution for in this retirement account is there, and employer's contribution is also there. So it's a social security scheme plus welfare scheme both, okay. From 1st January 2004 it is working, and it was extended in 2019 to other sectors also, apart from central government and the state government. But remember, armed forces are not covered under this particular new pension scheme. That's important. So this data is released by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, as the data was creating a lot of trouble. The non-release of this data of NSSO, that was creating a trouble. But now they are releasing the EPFO, ESI and NPS data for the employment perspective, okay. They are showing employment through these things, but that's again controversial, that how can you ascertain about the employment situation of the country by these datas. These are the social security measures, and we don't know that how many people are actually working continuously in those organizations. That's a big problem. Maybe they are registered once, but after that they have left the job. So that's a problem. So the questions are there. Write their answer in the comment section, and that's very important. The data, the PDF you will get on this particular group on Facebook. Send me a request, I would approve. And this is the page, and you will get the PDF on the Telegram channel also. Thanks a lot. Keep watching. It was Amit Saini.